Hello Stamper, welcome to French's video. I'm France Martin, independent demonstrator with Stamping Up, and today it's Stamp on the Go. We're going to use Helping Me Grow, and this stamp set is part of one of my class in the mail. If you are interested, visit my blog at frenchystamps.com. On top, you're going to see the Stamp on the Go. I did many, many cards with this set, so yes, it's very stamped. I did over 100 of them with this one for thank you cards. So you see it's been very well loved. So first thing, okay, I got a piece of cardstock here, 5.5 by 8.5. We're gonna fold this in two. And then I'm gonna put a layer on top, just a plain layer of 4 by 5.25. Right here. And we're going to cut that at 5.25. Now we're going to stamp on this one. I'm going to bring my foam because when it's photopolymer, it helps. It's time to change my blade. So this is a big stamp set. So I like to leave it down and bring, we're going to use Pool Party. And we're going to tap this here. That should be good. I see on the side, I get some Pool Party there. Bring this here. Everything's going to be Pool Party. I'm using one color for this stamp on the go. Give a good push. Let's raise this up. Uh-oh, see this? I had ink on the side there. So let's try one more time. So I get my absorber here. We're going to clean that. And if you see, I even cut in the center there. So let's be more careful when I tap this. And let's try that one more time. Oh, perfect. Voila. You don't want to tap your ink pad too hard. We're going to keep this. And you see those little corner there? We're going to add 4 corners. And I like the one with the little swirl to it. So we're going to put that right there. Make sure it's on the right side. So we're using only one color. That's it. And that would be nice in like Wisteria Wonder, I think, because it kind of looked like lilac. But the reason why I wanted Pool Party, it's because we get this beautiful glitter ribbon. It is very soft. It's not like our regular ribbon we add at Christmas. It's soft and it's easy to work with. So I'm going to cut about, oh, I'm going to say 6 inch. I say about because I'm not measuring too good here. We're going to do our faux bow. So you just do a loop around your finger. You want to leave it loose because you want to slide it off. And then again. Voila. Now let's get some, just a little bit here, a little bit there, because I want to raise that up. I'm going to bring my dimensional here. We're going to put that right in the center of this one. Is it one side more glitter than the other? Maybe so. So let's pay attention to this. Never. Oh. That didn't help me up. Here we go. Yeah, it is one side that it's more glitter than the other one. So just be careful when you twist this around. Here we go. Now we're going to put dimensional in every corner. Oh, I wanted to put a greeting. It's kind of too late to put a greeting because I get my dimensional. We're still going to try it though. I wanted to put my tanks right at the bottom here. And you know what? I said we were, we're going to put it in the blue too. Everything's going to be in the blue. Going to put that right there. Let's hope this is going to work. Yes, perfect. So now I got my tanks. Now we're going to remove those little doodads there. Make sure this is pushed down. I put some at each end of the ribbon, so then it's it won't move on me. Here we go. Back there, and we're going to mount that right there. Now we're going to take our scissors, we're going to cut that diagonal, and because I twist my thing, I'm going to use a glue dot to make sure it stays on the right side here. Usually I don't even put a glue dot there, but just because I twist my ribbon. Here we go. So now I got stay there. Voila, my friend, how simple it is. Now, if you want to bring the color out, I know it's stamp on the go, but even with that, it would be quick. You just take your aqua painter, make sure it's wet. And this is regular cardstock, so you don't want to put a lot because it's going to bow the paper. So you see, I just rub a little bit and that's going to bring the color. If that's not enough, you can come in here and then see, I wouldn't do all the flower. I would just add a little bit here and there. And if you do it right after you stamp, you don't even have to get some color out of your ink pad. So you, to get the color in the back of, you just squeeze and that bring the color there. That is it, my friend. Our simple, another thing, instead of the aqua painter, you can use some Wing of Stella to have a little bling. But see how clean and simple this is. This is it, my friend, for today. For all the supply product, visit my blog at frenchystamps.com. And I'm going to have all the information there. Thank you and have a great day.